Ladies and gentlemen, welcome, after a very long time, back to Challenging YouTubers with the Matt Dennis.
Hello, I'm once again stealing your channel from you, Harv.
You always, every time we start a video together, the first thing you say is, I'm stealing your channel.
It's the first thing you ever said when we made one of the videos together.
Oh, is it? Oh.
Yep.
Oh, nostalgia. Huh.
You said, because I was the first person to ever do kind of a co-op on the sound.
Yeah.
That I was stealing the channel. And it's stuck.
And it's stuck as your intro into my videos.
It's I'm stealing your channel.
We tried to restart. We tried to restart this series, didn't we?
Yeah, then university and your school got in the way.
Yeah, I would say I would use the excuse of my GCSEs, but to be honest, I really didn't work for them. So
yeah.
We probably would have had time, but yeah. No, you were busy with uni and stuff. And we kind of just, I think that was the period where I was getting a bit tired of KSP. But
yeah.
But that period has pretty much passed, and now we are back with, for those of you who don't know, the Challenging YouTuber series, in which we take, or we used to take, viewer-submitted challenges, but now it's kind of a bit more relaxed.
It's a half, yeah.
It's like half and half. We'll use our own ideas, but you are still free to submit your challenges for Matt and I.
We'll take your challenges as a baseline and expand on them.
Rather than sticking rigidly to them.
Yes.
Try and make them convenient for us to do, you know. Links are in the description. You can go to the forum page and you can tweet us, I suppose.
I was actually really happy with this response we got when we asked in the Dota video alone for the amount of feedback.
Oh, did we get a lot of submissions? I haven't really looked at them.
25-ish, I think.
Oh, that's pretty good. Yeah, I guess our channels really have grown since we started Series 1, which was, what, like 2 years ago?
Yeah, I remember first episode I had like 300 subs. So,
I can't believe it.
I'm on 10k now. And at that time, when I first approached you with the series, I had more subs than you.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you shot past me like 10 times in about a week.
The thing is, back then, my voice was about 3 octaves higher, so.
Yeah.
All right, should we actually begin? Today's challenge. Sure. Today's challenge is, would you care to explain?
You forgot, haven't you?
No, I know what it is. I'm just giving you a chance to talk.
Fair enough. Basically, what we're doing is we've placed 3 objects around the Kerbal Space Center. One on the VAB roof, one at the monolith that's about 2 kilometers away from the runway, and one on the launch pad. Now, what we have to do is we have to create a jet fighter or bomber or some kind of equivalent and destroy it without landing. So ideally, the rules are the first person to destroy all 3 objects in one run or destroy as many objects in total, in a 15-minute period, wins.
Yep. In one run, so we have to do it in one flight?
If we can.
Okay. So if we destroy one and then crash, I guess if we revert to launch, it should reappear, shouldn't it?
Should do, yeah.
And then we'll be able to go through them all again.
Should do.
Yeah, that seems fair enough. Yep. Makes sense.
Yep.
Alright, I'm going to get out the tracking center, go into the space plane hangar. I assume you're already in there.
You assumed wrong for probably the first time in this entire series. I was sitting on the main menu.
Oh my god, you never did that.
No, I always used to sit in the VAB or something.
That's crazy.
Okay, I'm in the VAB. No, space plane.
Yes, I'm also in the space plane hangar, not the VAB. And I guess we shall begin. We have how long to build? 15 minutes?
Yeah, so it'll be about 18 minutes from now, in theory.
Huh?
No, 18 minutes from
total.
The start of the record. God damn it.
Well, we're in about 4 minutes of audio recording now, so if we start now, go.
Now, go. Right.
I've just realised that I was designing a plane that had no engines.
That is probably gonna be a problem for you right there.
Yeah, maybe just slightly. Also, this challenge actually gives us reason to use the low altitude engines.
That's actually what I've got.
Which is quite surprising.
Go high.
Because there's basically no reason otherwise to actually use them.
Yeah, because in almost all situations it's better to go high altitude.
Yeah, if you're trying to get distance you want to go higher. If you're trying to get efficiency you want to go higher anyway. Speed, that's what I meant. Alright. For those of you who saw the first series of this, you'll know that I'm just the slowest builder in the space plane hangar. Something to do with trying to talk to you at the same time as building that makes me go so slow.
Your brain is obviously a lot slower than mine. You can't handle multiple commands.
No, I think it's the input of you that make my brain go slow.
Yeah, that would do it as well. Just the kind of brain numbing of my voice.
Yeah, you have that trait.
Yeah. It's a good trait, mostly. It's a good way to put your audience to sleep. Yeah. That's why I don't do commentary a lot.
But it is going to be useful in the Kerbal Pole Expedition.
Oh, God, yeah.
But you're away for that, so...
I am. I'm on holiday, I think. I'm pretty sure I'm on holiday.
I was just about to say, oh, it'll be great when you actually come join us. And then it's like, oh, wait, you're not coming.
I'm on holiday. Damn.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Sorry, Hal.
You can be there in spirit. We'll try and channel the power of the Matt Dennis. I've had an interesting idea to use the air intakes, which are reputed as being indestructible.
That is true. Don't they have... They used to have a ridiculously high crash tolerance.
Yeah, they still do. So I'm thinking if you use them, they won't actually destroy on impact. They have a higher chance of destroying it, I think.
That did not work. Staging is wrong. KSP, why do you do this to me?
There we go. I've got a weird plane. But there, I've got 6 bombs, and that ought to be enough, right?
You'd think so, yeah. 6 bombs, Jesus.
Well, yeah, I've mounted...
Well, I suppose that's 2 for each attempt.
Yeah, that was my thinking. Let me guess, have you got 3?
At the moment, I'm just testing 1 to see if it'll actually destroy it.
That does make sense. How far are we in? We have until 19 minutes, don't we?
Yeah, so we've got effectively 10 minutes left.
Alright, that's fine. 10 minutes to finish testing.
I hear air intakes are a thing that I have to do. I just completely forgot. It's like, right, let's launch a plane. Oh yeah, planes need air. Who knew?
Bomber plane Mark 1. Saving and launching, if there aren't any problems.
Come on. Started trying to learn StarCraft, so everything I do, I'm constantly spamming my keyboard and mouse now. It's rubbing off on me.
You're trying to increase your APM in KSP.
It's like I'm sitting drawing circles with my mouse. Oh, that did not work.
I got Planetary Annihilation in the Steam sales.
Steam sales, yeah. I thought about it. I didn't buy anything from the Steam sale. Really
I spent £43, which is about £10 more than I was expecting to.
Yeah. To be fair, of the games that you bought, you've got to admit, Witcher was worth the £3 that you'll have spent.
Oh, yeah. The Witcher 2, I played 30 hours within 4 days, and I only spent £3 on it. Yeah. That was The Witcher 2 Assassin's of Kings is a fantastic game. Also, my plane can't fly. Mm. It actually is terribly not aerodynamic whatsoever.
No, mine just keeps nose diving into the ground and flipping over. Oh.
And I thought I got good at planes recently. Okay, target in sight. Ah, I can't target the target.
I can't even plane.
I can't plane. Sound like Danny in his videos, how to plane, how to water.
How to Kerbal.
I don't know if he's made that yet. He probably should.
If he hasn't, he will have soon.
Yeah. Oh, my plane. Yeah, I still don't quite know how to plane, but I'm getting better. God damn it. It's just not stable at all. Doing crazy acrobatics to try and stay in the air, but it's futile.
Plane, please, lift off this time. Come on.
I didn't expect that the problem would be trying to fly the goddamn plane.
I can't even get mine to lift off, and it looks like it should. There's no reason why this plane should not lift off. In before everyone in the comments points out exactly why mine doesn't lift off.
Yeah. And dropping a bomb. Dropping 2 bombs. Dropping. Oh, they're at an angle. They're going to eject sideways.
Yeah, that's going to be a problem.
Yeah, that is going to be a problem. Also, the cartwheeling through the air is a slight problem, but nothing major.
Yeah, that's going to lower your accuracy just a little bit.
It would be incredible if it pulled it off, though, wouldn't it? It'd be so worth it.
Yeah. This might help stability a bit. Please work, please work, please work. I don't want to fail the first challenge because I can't even build a plane. admittedly, I've done worse on this series, like the motorbike episode, where I didn't even get anything in like 2 hours.
That was beautiful. We spent 2 hours recording.
Yeah, we recorded for 2 hours. You got a beautifully perfect working bike. Mine just fell over on every attempt.
Yeah. I just had a better design philosophy, what can I say?
Well, my design philosophy was get a fuel tank and put two wheels on the same side and then try and counterbalance it out. Yeah, that didn't work.
You started off with a broken idea.
Yeah. And then continued to further break the plan.
It's like when you've invested so much time into something that you can't really bear to just let it go.
Yeah. It's a joke. It's a joke.
No one understands. You got to have British humour.
Yep, nobody gets British humour. No, not even Brits.
Not even Brits. Just about to say that. Direct hit, and it didn't destroy it. Actually, it may not have been a direct hit.
I have a chance. It's a slim chance, given it's 19 minutes, but...
Oh yeah, we've passed the deadline. We're technically flying now.
Technically, you're already winning.
Does a direct hit count as, like, half a point, even if it doesn't destroy it?
I think we're going to have to settle for that, yes.
Well, as long as I can get one of those, because I'm not convinced what I just did was one, but hey.
Please fly, plane. I've given you a wider wheelbase. You should fly now.
I'm looking forward to seeing what terrible design choices you've made.
Mine doesn't look bad.
It just doesn't fly.
It just does not fly at all. At least it's made it to the end of the runway this time.
Aesthetics and being able to fly are probably two different things.
Yes, it flies! Oh,
or not.
Yes. I've made something that works.
Oh, I missed it both times.
Okay. 20 minutes technically, but shut up. I'll count that.
That's my design. We're done with testing. I guess I've got my design as well, then. I'm just going to have to hope the intakes work. Okay, well, I'm going to try and... I'm going to finish this testing flight. But now we're technically in the actual...
Okay, that was my test flight.
We're technically in the actual competition now, so...
Yes. Right, I need to add two other bombs. Because I've done all my testing, I know exactly what works now.
You know what works, do you?
Yes.
You know what flies.
It flies, and I've got three shots that may not actually destroy anything.
You've got three shots to hit three objects.
Yeah.
With bombs that probably, possibly, almost definitely won't work.
Yeah. I didn't say it was a great plan, Harv.
Well, you're in about the same situation as me, except I have five. Or six, actually. I think I've got six.
In actual fact, doing that just completely broke my entire plane, by the way. I would like to point that out.
And we also are supposed to land back at the runway, but that's kind of out of the question right now. We can't even hit the things.
That's true. We can't actually hit anything yet.
No, I've landed back at the runway. It's fine.
Oh, you've landed it. You're all right.
Yeah, just testing that I could do that. Okay. Reverting to launch, and I'm going to begin my proper attempts now. 3 minutes late.
Ready?
Okay, give a countdown.
3, 2, 1, go.
Engines on.
Mine are on as well.
So which ones are you going to try and go for first? What's going to be your flight path?
I'm going to try and get the monolith first, head across to the VAB, then do a quick U-turn and try and get the actual landing pad. There we go. Words.
I think just to make it interesting in video comparison, I'll try and do the same thing as you. Because then... Well, the thing is, we'll disintegrate and we'll be completely out of time anyway, but hey.
Yeah.
Might as well try it. I have five bombs.
Okay, there we go.
This is never going to work.
Mine took off.
If I can even destroy one, I'll probably be at an advantage to you.
Yeah. At this point, I think... We started the plan with like, oh yeah, if we'll destroy them all, it's going to be easy as hell.
Yeah.
It's like, now it's like, get a plane to work and yours don't destroy anything.
I haven't even hit directly yet. We don't know whether they destroy anything.
That's true.
All right, I'm looping back for my first pass over the target site.
Okay, so am I.
And we shall see.
And I hit it, I think.
Did it destroy?
No.
Hardly surprising. Coming in low, I've got my throttle on 1/3.
Mistakes were made. I set them all onto the same.
You didn't do your action group or your staging.
I set them all onto the same stage.
Well played. Well played. GG.
Mm-hmm. Just gotta do it all again.
I'm going way too fast. I'll never be able to hit it at this speed. I've got to slow down. Oh, I got a direct hit, and it didn't destroy it.
Oh, well.
That was a direct hit. Ah.
I think mine was a little bit out, actually. Not sure I hit it fully.
I'm going to go around for another pass.
Right, there we go. All staged now. Let's try again. We have effectively 10 minutes left.
We all, every single time, we set ourselves a challenge and we're pretty confident that we can do it, and then we come nowhere near, and we end up botching the winner state.
Yep.
Because currently I've got a direct hit, so you know.
So technically you're half a point
ahead.
Puts
me as half a point ahead. Out of what was supposed to be 3 points in total, I'm half a point ahead.
Yeah.
Going in for a second pass. Another direct hit. Yeah, my bombs basically aren't destroying it.
Mm.
They're not powerful enough.
I don't think mine will be either, to be honest.
What are you using?
Those I-beams.
Oh, you're using structural parts?
Yeah.
I don't reckon they will be, you know.
No, I don't think they will be either, but...
Well, I've now got 3 bombs left.
Yes.
I've hit with 2 and I still haven't managed to destroy the target. This isn't looking particularly good. Oh, you missed, which means you're basically out of the running for the first for the first flight.
I changed it, so I've got 4 attempts.
Oh, okay, so we now both have 3 attempts left.
Yeah.
Right, except I'm about to crash.
I'm basically flying in as low as possibly, as I possibly can, just to try and get as much accuracy on it.
Well, I crashed, so...
Well, there's your problem.
If I was half a point ahead, but you're still alive... I guess that kind of like...
Yeah.
Even.
I think we're both on even ground at the moment.
Thing is, now I'm reverting to launch. I've got 5 bombs again.
Hmm.
Call it bombs. They're more like feathers.
Missed. Although I did hit the monolith. Okay, I'm going to go for the launch pad this time.
God, why do we do space plane challenges?
I don't know, they're the hardest thing, one of the hardest things to build, in theory.
Yeah, they are. In a game about rocket science, planes are harder.
Yeah. That didn't work. I missed. Okay, back to the Space Center. Let's try that again. So far we're both on 0 points, effectively.
Yeah, pretty much. According to the initial rules, yeah.
Yeah.
But we kind of, like, just... guess at what the rules are supposed to be halfway through.
I don't think I've had any confirmed hits yet.
Oh, I destroyed one.
That's 1 point to you. We'll keep that.
Yes. 1 point to me. As long as we do it within flights, I reckon they count, even if it's not there. Because we're probably going to crash at some point, so we should be able to restart.
I deliberately crashed mine because I missed 2 of them in a row, so nothing I could do from there.
Yeah. Alright, so I'm now on 1 point.
Yep, 1 point to you.
I'm going in for my second pass. Or, well, my first pass on the second bomb.
Mm-hmm.
Why did you call them bombs?
Well, what else are they?
The tanks, the targets. Targets would have been a better word.
Shh. Don't question it.
I can't really criticise you for having a bad vocabulary.
Not really, given that I made the entire world for you.
Yeah, well, I was thinking more about the fact that, given that I say interesting and however far too much.
Yeah, I think that was about maybe 20 metres too late. Oh, I'm not going to manage this.
Yeah,
not in 5 minutes.
I went for the launch site and the VAB one on the same pass, and I missed both.
Yeah.
Didn't even get contact, and now I'm probably going to crash.
Yeah, I crashed as well.
Pull up. Yeah. Well.
You crashed, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. We'll keep your 1 point.
Yeah, I guess it counts, seeing as it was done at a point in time. And we might as well basically go over what we said for every single episode in the last series, which was that try and make them convenient.
Yeah.
Like,
don't make them several hours long.
Despite its appearance, this is fairly convenient because we can do it in less than an hour. And it's just here at the Space Center.
Exactly. Whereas
with, like,
up.
A grand tour of planets in the Kerbal Solar System. Yeah.
I hit it, but I immediately crashed afterwards.
Did it explode?
It did.
Oh, it did. Yeah, well, that counts then, I think.
I'm accepting that.
Yeah, all right. We're back to 1 point each.
Okay, I'm going to go for a different one this time. Because there's no point going for the same one again.
Well, yeah, I guess so.
Kind of boring.
All right, I will go for the other one then. I was about to just carry on going for the monolith one, which seems
to
be the easiest to hit.
It is, because you can immediately turn left and come back round and hit it.
Yeah.
I'm going to try and do the same one for the VAB this time.
I'll
skip
the
launch
VAB
pad
as well. Ah, it's landed on the right-hand side of the helicopter pad, isn't it?
Yeah, as you're taking off, it's on the right. As you're coming up towards it from the sea, it's on the left.
Yeah, which means I probably have to approach it from that direction.
Yeah.
Well, we're 1 point apiece, and we have about 3 minutes left.
Yep.
Might end up being a draw, unless one of us can destroy it.
It could possibly be a draw at this rate. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn around and do a little full U-turn. Turn left. There we go. Nope.
Your crackling is back.
Oh, God. I'll try and fix. Fix not found, no matter how much I tilt my head.
Ooh, I don't think it destroyed it. No, it didn't.
Lift. Lift. Thank you. 30 meters. That was close. Okay, I'm going to go for the runway. No, launch pad one.
Yeah, I think the launch pad's going to be slightly easier to hit than the VAB.
Yeah.
Just because it's on a wide open pedestal, rather than hidden beside the helicopter pads.
I didn't want that one to be easy. Plus, I didn't want to have to try and land on the runway, on the actual helicopter pad.
How did you land them there anyway? Did you use parachutes in the end?
No, I used RCS and very, very slowly manoeuvred it.
Oh, right.
Okay, I missed the launch pad. I hit it just short, I think. I don't know. I'll have to check the recording. I might have hit it, but not actually destroyed it. Because it certainly lived.
Now that we've both managed to destroy them, it's only destroying that we're really counting, so...
Yeah.
Those half points don't count anymore?
No. We've both managed to get 1 point, so...
So we've proved it's possible, which is the most painful
thing. It's possible, yeah.
Because now we know it's possible, we can't actually hit them.
I managed to destroy mine in one hit, which was good.
I think that's what I managed earlier, but...
Yeah. Thought you hit yours in two and destroyed it.
Maybe I did, but I don't think it actually carries over damage.
I'm not sure.
I'm pretty sure there is no damage rating on parts.
Yeah. To be a good idea if there was.
Another direct hit, but it didn't destroy it.
Yeah. No half points anymore.
No. And it just crashed into the side of the vehicle assembly building. I didn't pull
up. That's going to be
enough.
A problem.
Yeah, considering I've got no wings. I'm still alive and I'm still flying.
Yeah,
I've got canards. Maybe I can glide down with just these.
Yeah.
If I can land this, I get 12 points.
Yes, that's how it works.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. Maybe. Okay. What do you know? I kind
turning
of
around. Turning around. I'm going to try and slow down for this.
Looks like we have time. Actually, we don't have time. That's 35 minutes.
Okay.
Time is up. We have 1 point each.
Mm-hmm.
Which means it is a draw.
Effectively so, yep. In before I hit it and destroyed it on my second go.
What a pathetic first episode.
Yeah.
God damn. We need some good challenges.
I managed it after the time recorded. Managed it after. So in effect, I won 20 seconds late.
Oh, you got another hit 20 seconds afterwards.
Yeah.
Doesn't count.
No, it doesn't.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching the first episode of Challenging YouTubers Season 2, or Series 2, depending on your nationality. We both failed, I think. Neither of us won, although Matt would have won.
Yes, I would have won, had we had 20 seconds longer. But...
Gotta play by the rules.
Yes.
If you want to submit your own challenges, you can do so at the links in the description, etc.
Yep. Thank you very much for watching.
Yeah, thank you very much for watching, and we shall see you all next time. The next episode will be uploaded to Matt's channel.
The link
to that is also in the description. We'll be alternating between the two.
At thematdennis16 if you want to go check it out now.
Yeah. Thanks for watching.
Thank you for watching.
And we'll see you all next time.
Bye.